In this video, I'll give you a quick tour of the WeWeb editor so you're not lost when you first start building. So the first thing you have here is the top bar. So the top bar allows you to go back to your dashboard where you see all your projects. Here you can open or close a navigator. The navigator is where you have all your HTML elements. So your HTML elements are the sections and the blocks of content that you have on a page. You also have access to variables. We'll go into this later in the course. For now, let's focus on design. So with design, the important thing is the HTML, so the elements that are on the page, which you can see in the HTML tree in the navigator on the left. And whenever you select an element on the page, an HTML element, you have CSS properties that are displayed on the right, where you can, for example, make the text bigger or smaller. And again, in this right sidebar, you have other specific settings related to an element or workflows. Workflows that you trigger here are front-end logic. So again, we'll cover this in dedicated videos, but for now, the important thing to understand is that you have the page that you're designing in the center, the HTML elements that make up the page on the left, and the CSS properties where you can design each element however you want it on the right. If you need to add an element, you can access basic elements right here, or you can go into our UI kit and have ready-made sections like the top navigation or the responsive sidebar or custom forms, all of that. We'll go into more detail afterwards for each of those elements, so don't worry if anything is unclear at the moment. It's just a general overview of what you can find in WeWeb. And then you can switch to preview mode here when you need to see how it looks on a page. You can do this. You can go into tablet preview. You can here you see the breakpoints of the tablet. We'll cover this a bit. We'll cover this at length in a video about responsive design. So you can move this around to check out how it looks on a tablet or mobile as well. So that's really like the basics of what the WeWeb editor looks like for design. You have a lot of other options here, like to add a page, for example. Plugins is where you will add data sources and authentication and maybe extensions if you need charts, for example. So by default, you don't have any chart elements to design with, but if you add the plugin, then you will have access to chart components. So whenever you're stuck with design, you may look at plugins and extensions and see if you find something that will help you with your design. Here is for user authentication. This is when you have users that are using your app. This is for data collections. Again, don't worry too much about this for now. We'll go into each of the submenus as we move along through the course. Right now, we're focusing on design. So let's do exactly that. That's it. You've got a general idea of how things work in the WeWeb editor. Don't worry if it seems overwhelming at first. You will quickly get the hang of it as you start building.